Hi there, this is how Tmux looks out of the box, and this is how it looks in my setup. Over the years, I built up a configuration that not only looks pretty sweet, but also provides a really good user experience, and I'm gonna share it with you. But a little break first. I've noticed, and this is super cool, that a huge chunk of you, my viewers, are from Germany, so Hallo liebe Zuschauer, and especially for you, I've added German subtitles to this video. I mean, your English is probably fantastic, but check them out. And no matter where are you from, you can enable English subtitles, so it's easier to understand my accent. Okay, so Tmux. It's a terminal multiplexer, which means it allows you to run multiple terminal programs in a single terminal window, and easily switch between them, or into multiple panes, allowing you to have, you know, all your cool hacking stuff going in the same window. This is also really useful when you work on a remote server, since your session won't get zapped if you lose a connection. So you can just reconnect and pick up right where you left off. If you don't use Tmux yet, I think you should give it a try. And now let me show you how to configure it. So the Tmux configuration is a plain text file with a bunch of Tmux commands. It's located in your home directory in the .tmux.conf file. But I recommend you to put it into the .config/tmux folder according to the XDJ standard. And here, let's add our first change, a custom prefix key. So let's unset the default prefix Ctrl B and then set it to the backtick, which is not that common key in programming except for Markdown programmers like me. In case you need to type an actual backtick, you can just press it twice. Easy. Now, instead of Ctrl plus B, which is pretty hard to press, especially with numbers, to switch between windows, we can use a single key to trigger Tmux commands. I got hooked on this prefix key years ago, exactly because it works so well with top row. And I will never switch to alternatives like Ctrl plus A or Ctrl plus space, even though they are valid options too. But maybe you will like Ctrl plus A. Anyway, speaking of numbers, Tmux, like all real programmers, starts counting from zero. But in practice, it makes our most frequent window hard to access, since it breaks the order. We can fix that in our config by setting base window and pane indexes to 1. Low programmers should be happy about that. Now, let's make Tmux look a bit better. First thing is to enable RGB, aka True Color support, so all the programs, for example Vim, run inside Tmux can use it. And we can get normal looking colors. What configuration will and what will not work depends on your terminal, but I have bound this to be the most compatible settings. So now instead of this, where I run my NeoVim by the way, inside Tmux, I have this. Okay, let's do something about that bar at the bottom. I like it to be clean and minimal, without the background colors. The only two things I really care about seeing down there are my windows with their status and their current session name. To achieve that, let's first remove the background color, then clean the left status completely, and set the right status to the session name with a dimmed color. Now I like to make my windows indicators minimal too, displaying only a dot representing it, with the perfectly balanced Tanis purple for the active window. I also prefer to have indications if windows have a zoomed pane with a yellow color. And if a pane in another window is looking for attention via bell character, I want that dot to turn red, so I don't miss it. Okay, but with just dots, you cannot tell which numbers corresponds to which window if you delete one in the middle. So enabling the renumber windows option is a must. It keeps everything sequential. This way, the window's actual number always matches its position in the status bar. But alternatively, you can use these minimalistic statuses with window names or with numbers. Okay, now let's do something about the borders. Currently, they are too bold and distracting, looking like this. I set pane border lines to simple. This enables cleaner ASCII characters and makes the border look much slicker and thinner, like this. This is my own colors now. I like to use dimmed colors for inactive panes. And for active, again, Tanis instead of default green. And before the most important part, a few more quality of life tweaks. Set escape time to 0. Since I don't type escape sequences manually, I'm not sure who does that. And my terminal sends them instantly for key combinations. I don't want any extra delay for the most important key in Vim. Then I enable mouse support, even though I rarely use it. It's pretty handy to have it on mobile devices or for demonstration purposes. I also increase repeat time to 1 second. This way it's easier to pass multiple commands to Tmux without pressing the prefix key every time. And lastly, I increase history limit to 10,000 lines just to have more scrollback history. Now another key part for usability, keybindings. The most important two are for window splitting. Default prefix quote and prefix percent makes not much sense, and I prefer to have prefix V with prefix dash for vertical split and prefix H and prefix pipe for horizontal split. Hold up, you think, why are you remapping the HK? I have to confess. For many years, instead of HJKL, de facto standard for GigaChat beam lowers, I used WASD movements instead. Yeah, and that's crazy. But let's forget about that for a second. Anyway, if you don't want to remap the HK like I do, you can stick with just prefix pipe for horizontal splits. It still makes more sense. Next up, F should be for full screen, right? So I remap pane zooming to prefix F. In the past, I also tried to make some experimental bindings for prefixless commands with the Alt key like this. So instead of prefix 1, for example, I can use Alt plus 1. This didn't stick with me in practice. Maybe you will like it. Okay, and let's not forget about our shell. I like to add some aliases to my Z shell config to make the usage experience even better. I keep it simple with just three main ones. TM for creating a session, TL for checking out current sessions, and TA to attach to some. Sometimes I choose the session I need, but most of the time I just attach to any random one and then switch between them with prefix session selector. Prefix S. Yeah, and Tmux has a very good support for plugins and a huge ecosystem of them. You might want to check out this, TPM, the Tmux plugin manager. This is the only plugin you need to install manually and it will take care of the rest. Tmux auto-reload to automatically apply changes from your config file. Tmux FZF for fuzzy searching, then switching between sessions and windows, searching for commands, key bindings, and much more with FZF. Great tool, by the way. Tmux Sensible. It has some better values for common options, like what I showed you in the video, but these two option sets don't overlap much. And last plugin group, Tmux Resurrect and Tmux Continue, to save and restore Tmux sessions across reboots. I try to keep my configuration as simple as possible, so I don't use plugins at all anymore. And this is the end. If you want to configure your Git in a similar way, I have another video on that. Check it out. Also, the full configuration is available on my GitHub. You can see both links on the screen or get them from the pinned comment. Subscribe to get more videos like this, and I will see you in the next one.